Here's what I did with Midjourney AI. I typed Darth Vader smoking a cigar, and this is what I got. Then I typed a beautiful photo taken with a Nikon D850 of the Seine River in Paris at golden hour. That's what I got. Then I type Spider-Man playing chess with Bruce Lee in New York, 8K in the style of Drew Struzan. You don't know who Drew Struzan is? He's an amazing artist who did most of the posters for Star Wars in Indiana Jones. An old painter, amazing. Two lovers in Paris. That's what I got. A beautiful photo of New York City at night with lots of snow, 8K. That's what I got. A beautiful photo taken with a Nikon D850 of Yoda at a coffee, Paris at golden hour. That's what I got. A beautiful painting of Paris in the style of Claude Monet. And that's what I got. Now, this is crazy. This is computer-generated AI photography or painting. It's not photography, but you know, as an artist who likes to create anything, I love to play around with that. And it's kind of cool because I'm using it a lot for mood boards or for ideas that I want to do. And I just want to show you how it works because I think as a photographer, if you use Lightroom or Photoshop, it's good to know how that exists and how it's been done. So my name is Serge Remini. I like to teach photography, Lightroom, Photoshop, or even other plugins like this one as easy and as fun as possible. Now, if you stay until the end, I'm gonna show you a little trick in Photoshop and Lightroom to get your creation into a very high resolution file where you will be able to print your creation. It's unbelievable. This technology has blown me away. I've been playing with it every day. So let's jump in and let me show you. So first, how do you install it? You go to midjourney.com and you click here on join the beta. Basically, don't get confused by all this symbol you see on the screen. Midjourney uses something called Discord, which is just a very simple software to send comment to like a supercomputer up in the cloud, and it creates the image and send the computer back to you. So once you register, it's gonna ask you to register on Discord. I already did it. It's free to create an account on Discord. Now, when you're getting started, you get to like to 25 images and then you have to pay either $10 per month or $30 per month. Now, I'm not being sponsored by this. In fact, I would love to get sponsored by Midjourney. If you can contact me, Midjourney, I would love to get sponsored. But I'm just so in love and everybody I showed this technology to really liked it. Let me show you how it works. Once it's installed, you come to this very confusing page and basically you can just jump here into like the newbie. It's basically, they call that room. So let's go to newbie 119. And you can see people are typing things and they're getting like these four images. And you can see in real time what other people are doing. Now, just in case you want to know, anything you create on this actually, especially for free, belongs to the AI. You can use it with some copyright. There's some usage you can have on when you use a free version. On the paid version, I have the paid version because I'm using it every day, $30 per month. Then you can actually sell your work, but they still have some copyright. Just so you know, what you can do is Google copyright Midjourney if you want to get the exact term. But the basic idea is if you don't pay, nothing belongs to you, can't sell it. If you pay, you can eventually sell the photos, but I think they still belong to them. But look, it's still a really cool tool. So let's try to create an image together. Let's try to create an image. So the way it works is you type slash and then imagine, or you can just click on that, and that's what they call a prompt. And then you can type anything that you want. For example, let's try a beautiful photo of Paris under the snow at blue hour. Now, I'll give you a trick that I learned. The software has different level of updates, and I'm using the latest update, which is 4. So to do that, you have to press dash, dash, V. That's how you tell a command, 4. That's the only thing a bit complex you have to learn. Everything else is like natural language. So a beautiful photo of Paris under the snow at blue hour. When you do that, it's gonna create 4 images, and it's gonna take about a minute. Okay, so the first 4 images were created, but where are they? It's kind of confusing because you see what everybody else is doing. So you have to go back until you see in brown. When you see brown here, it means it's your creation. So you see 4 images, and then there is like U1, U2, U3, U4, V1, V2, V3, V4. Do not be afraid of these symbols. It's very easy. U stands for upgrade, so you like the photo. So first you do is you click on it, and you can see, look at this, how beautiful that is. So it's Paris under the snow at the blue hour. It doesn't really look like photo, more like a painting, but it's beautiful. I love to create anything. So for example, I'm like, oh, I like the first one and the third one. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4. I want to see if they can do some variation of number 1. So what you can do is you can click here and you can click on V1, and that's going to create 4 variations from this one. And then I really like the number three, which is this one here, upgrade number three. And now that's gonna take another minute. And so what it's gonna do, it's gonna create four variations of my first photo and then one upgrade. What's annoying is that your creation is getting mixed up in everybody else, but just remember the brown thing. Now, at the end of this video, I'll show you, if you have the subscription, how you could put it on your own Discord server, which is really cool. It's super easy. That way you only see your creation and nobody else's creation. That's how I use the software. So for now, let's see what it's gonna come up with. Okay, so this one you can see is brown. So I know this one is mine. And let's go to the upgrade version. So this is the upgrade version. So I'm going to click on it. And if I'm not mistaken, the resolution is like 1024 by 1024, which is really not enough to print. And again, at the end of this video, I'll show you how to upscale that. A couple of really cool tricks in Lightroom and Photoshop to be able to make huge print if you need to. But I really like it. So here's the trick. And now it only works if you use a --V4 is I'm going to click on beta upscale redo. All that's going to do is make the photo go from 1024 to 248 and it's going to give it a lot more detail. Okay. So while that's doing that, let's look at the variation that we did. So where is my variation? Here is the variation. And you see they're very similar, but I kind of like different cars in the street. I think the one I like the most is this one. No, I think the first one is the one I like the most. So the first one, I'm going to upscale the first one. I'm going to click on U1, and that's going to upscale the first photo out of the four. All right, so you see that's the version 1024 by 1024, which has not been upscaled. And let's look at the upscale version. And look at that. It's got a lot more detail. And if I right-click and I can now right-click and save the image. Another resolution is 2048 pixels by 2048 pixels. It's pretty good, and I'm going to show you how to boost that even more crazy. So let's go back really quick to the other image that we had, which is this one. That's the one I picked. And same thing, I'm going to click on beta upscale redo. And again, you only have this option if you type --V(4). --V(4). All right, once you have a photo that you really like this one I really like, what I advise you to do is click on this little icon to say that you love that image, because it will help you later to find it faster. So now let's see if the other photo has been upscaled in beta with a lot more details. And here we are. Here's the full quality. It's got a lot more detail. Same thing, I'm gonna save that image. All right, if at any point you want some help on this software, you can just click here, --help. It's gonna give you like a whole bunch of resources that you can get help on. You have like a full manual. Don't get overwhelmed. It's actually really simple. Really simple. Also, if you want to subscribe and pay so you're not limited to 25 image and you want to have your own server, you can do /subscribe. Again, I'm not being sponsored. And you press enter and you will see the different option you have. Open subscription page. So you can see here $10 per month or $30 per month, which is the one I have at $30 per month, because I'm only limited to 200 image a month and I'm crazy. I'm doing like 400 or 500 image per month. It's crazy. So don't forget, once you have an image you like, click here. Okay, so now I want to show you two things. So now let's say you paid for the software and you want to have it in your own server. So first of all, you have to go to Discord and you have to create a new server by clicking here on the plus. You call it whatever, create my own server. So click here and follow the instruction. It's really fast. Once you've done that, you click here. On the right side, you have to find the Midjourney bot. You click on it and you click it, add to server. And you choose the server that you just created. I created one for my wife and one for me. I'm actually using the one for my wife. Once you have your own server, it should appear on the left. You can click here. And what's amazing is you only see your own creation. So let's do something crazy. A photo taken with the Sony A7 R4 of a beautiful horse running on the beach in Iceland. And then --V(4). Don't forget that. When you press enter, if you see it becomes brown, you're good. And you can see here, this is only my creation. There's nobody else's creation. So that's really cool. And you just have to wait. You know, that's why I like the $10 or the $30 version. Again, I'm not being sponsored. Again, Midjourney, if you're watching this, please call me. Would love to get sponsored. By the way, guys, while this is being done, I have a new coaching program that I'm doing that costs $47 per month. It's a new membership, which is really cool, where we go on Zoom together with a few photographers and I give you some of my best raw files and we retouch them together. Really cool. Plus I give you something called the success pass, which is basically I made one pass to become a world-class photographer. It's pretty long, but it's only one pass and you just have to follow at it. And it's a lot of live session. It's really cool. If you want to take your photography to the next level, you can become a member of that group. You can test it for free for 2 weeks, clicking the link under the video. And if you do that, you can also get for free my latest Lightroom book, a really cool t-shirt called Passion passionate photographer, and 3 cheat sheets, one on how to use your camera, one how to compose better as a photographer, and the last one, the 13 best shortcuts in Lightroom. All of that is free. You just have to pay shipping and handling, and then you can test my membership for 2 weeks if you like it. So this video is not sponsored by Midjourney, but by myself for my own training. It's a cool way of teaching. I can only take a few people. Check out the coaching if you want me to coach you. Okay, so this is what I got. A photo of a horse in Iceland. I like it, but I want like something more sunset. So what I can do is I can just take that, Command C, and then go again. Imagine, I can say at sunset. I think that would be better. And let's try that again. Also, huge favor to ask you, if you can slam that like button, it really helps me to make more videos. Take just 1 second. If you can like it, I would love it. Merci beaucoup. Thank you very much. Okay, so we're back. Let's see with sunset. Ooh, I love this one. Look at this one. So let's upscale this one. I'm gonna upscale photo number 4. Okay, so the first upscaling has been done. Look at that, beautiful. So now it's time to beta upscale redo, which is what's gonna make it 2048 pixels. And next I'm gonna show you how to boost that to even crazy, crazy numbers in Lightroom or Photoshop. All right, so here's the final result with all the details. Look at that, it's beautiful. I'm gonna right click, save image. And then what I usually do is I'm just gonna test that photo. So I've got a whole bunch of photo that I want to actually print. So I'm gonna drag and drop it on my Lightroom Classic logo. I'm gonna say add. And remember right now, this photo is, if you press I, you can see it's 2048 by 2048. Now here's the super mega trick. If you right click and you go to enhance, you have a new option called Super Resolution, Create Enhance, and that's gonna multiply by 2 the resolution. So that's how you do it in Lightroom, if you're a Lightroom user. So you'll see there's 2 versions now. There's a version which is the 28 by 48, and the other version which is the 4000 by 4000, which is pretty cool. I would personally go in Lightroom and maybe, you know, open the shadows, add a more contrast, touch the black, maybe add a bit of clarity and texture to make it pop even more, and boom, I would send it to a lab. You know, I would just export it, right click, export as a JPEG. You know, JPEG, make sure you don't resize to fit. I always, when I print, I export quality 94, export, and you can just send that to a lab and you're gonna get an amazing, amazing print. Now, even more crazy in Photoshop, what you can do, I'm gonna go to Photoshop, I'm gonna go to File, Open. This is the same image. And if you want to do it in Photoshop, you just go to Image, Image Size, make sure you are in pixel, and you can literally go x2. Boom, and voila. And then you can just go to File, Export, Export as JPEG, save for the web. It's a good profile. The quality, you put it at like 99%. I always put like 99% quality. And then you just decide where you save it, and that's ready to be printed. All right, I hope you enjoyed this. I know it's not photography, but it's so fun. Give it a try or not, whatever. I just wanted to share that passion with you. Like, I just love trying all that stuff. Make sure you try my membership if you get a chance. It's totally free. You can work with me for 2 weeks, see if you like it or not. And I'll see you in another video. Mesdames et messieurs, au revoir.